Hello friends, today I will show you how to download Visual Studio 2022 and install it on your Windows 10 machine. So let's get started. Go to google.com and type Microsoft Visual Studio download. So that should take you to the downloads page. So go to this page here. So it will go to this URL, visualstudio.microsoft.com/downloads. You can directly also go to this URL. You can find this URL in the description below. Now in this page, what do you have? You have this Visual Studio 2022 version 17.0, which is the latest version as of January 2022. You have three different types of Visual Studio available: Community Edition, Professional, Enterprise. Now there is a bit of difference between all these three. Community Edition is free for you, and Professional and Enterprise, there will be charges for this. If you have a license key, then you can download these two editions, and then you can enjoy the benefits as part of that. However, for usually Community Edition is also very good. There are a lot of features available, but if you need advanced debugging, or if you need like advanced testing tools, then you can go for Enterprise editions. You can see the difference if you go to compare editions. Let me open this and you will be able to see the difference here like this. So these blue dots means all these features are available, and wherever there is white dots, it means some of the features are not available. Like for example, testing tools, you can see in Community Edition you only have unit testing available, whereas code coverage, Microsoft fix, all these things are not available in Community Edition and also in Professional Editions. But in Enterprise Editions, these things are available. Similarly, you can go and check other features. But I think for normal, regular developers, this Community Edition is also very good. So let's go ahead and download this. Yeah, I want to tell you one more thing. If you want to download if you don't have Windows, if you have Mac, then there is a 19 edition still available for Mac, and then you have the older editions. If you scroll down, you can see here older downloads. Open that and you can see in this page that you have the older downloads available. So 2019, 2017, 2015, all these different versions are available. So you can go to this page. I will also put a link in my description box to this page. So if you want to download older versions, you can go here and download it. So now let's click on this button. So when I do this, it will download the setup. So this is basically an installer. It will download it. Let me double click this. Now it is asking me to install it. It will ask you whether you want to allow this. So click on yes. And this is the Visual Studio installer. So this will help us to download Visual Studio 2022. Okay, so this is the installer, which is a separate software. Visual Studio 2022 is a separate software. But this installer will actually help you to select certain features, or we call it as like workloads. And you can then customize your Visual Studio, and then you can download and install those things. So let's click on this continue button. Since I already have Visual Studio installer installed, so you can see it has kind of instantly it completed, but it will actually in real time, it will take some time to download this. So it will take some time to get it ready. So let's wait for a few minutes. And then this window will open up. Right now, this window has now opened up. So here you can see these are the workloads I was talking about. So you can see different like ASP.NET and web development is available. Azure development, SDKs, tools, etc. are available. If you are a Python developer, then you may need like Python development tools. So those things are also available. And like this, likewise, you have Node.js. And now this is for web and cloud, for desktop developments and mobile developments, you have different workloads available. Similarly for game development also, some workloads are available. Then there are other tools as well. Okay, like for example, if you are an Office SharePoint, if you want to customize something there, so this workload is available. Like this Visual Studio Extension development workloads are available. So you can select whatever you want. So for me, I will select this ASP.NET Azure development. So that should be fine for me. So you can see the space here. It is saying 6.93 GB. So that is the space which needs to be there available. So I will recommend if so you should have a little bit more space than this, so that your operating system and your software works can work properly. If you have less space, then the performance will be affected. So have sufficient space to download it. The more space you have, the better it is. So but have, yeah, at least more than this. So for example, if it is taking nearly 6.93, then I'll recommend have at least 10 GB or higher. Okay, if you have 15 GB, very good. If you have 20 GB, 30 GB, excellent. Similarly, you can see the location here is by default selected C program files, Microsoft Visual Studio 2022. You can change it. You can click on this change here link here, and you can select any other location. If you have space in D drive, maybe go for D drive, but C drive is the recommended drive, because by default you have your operating system in C drive, and if you have Visual Studio in the same drive, the performance will be better compared to installing it in different drives. Okay, so try to install it in the same drive where your operating system is there. Now let's go ahead and install. Now I have selected here install. Now this is by default selected install while downloading. You can actually download all and then install later. Okay, that is also possible, but that will take time, because install it is a big, like 6.93 GB is you know, it will take some time to download all these packages, and then download all and then install later. Again, installing itself will also take time, right? So if you do both the things in parallel, it will be quicker. So that's why by default it is suggesting you to do this, and I will go with that default option. Click on install. It will take some time. All right, so Visual Studio Community 2022 edition has now been installed on my system, and you can see 17.0.5 is the latest version as of January 2022. So once it is installed, it will automatically launch it like this. Or you can still launch it from this window by clicking this button, or you can go to start and you will find it there, and you can also launch it from there. So let's go to this window. Now you will see something like this. If you want to create a new project, click on create a new project. If you already have a project created and it is available in your system, then you can go and open a project. It is unlikely, because this is the first time you are installing this. So let's go to create a new project. So now here it will open up all the different templates available. Now there are different types of projects which you can create using Visual Studio 2022. It supports .NET Core 6, and you can also see different types of projects which you can create here. Like you can see Azure Functions, ASP.NET Core Web App, the Blazor Server App. So there are a lot of different templates which has been provided. When you select a particular template, by default it will create some files which will help you to build up that project. Okay, to you can use that those default files, and you can build up your code on top of that. Okay, so it will be quicker for you. So what we can do is I can create a simple console app, and then we can use that as an example on how to create a simple application using Visual Studio 2022. Now I typed here console, although the console app was coming on top. I typed it here so that I can show you that different console apps which are already available. Now here you can see .NET framework is written here, console app .NET framework. So this is basically the older .NET framework, and these are the new .NET core. So this console apps will be using .NET core, whereas this will be using the old one, which is .NET framework. Okay, so let's click on this and click on next. So it will create a .NET console app. So let's call it Hello World, and click on next. So you can see .NET 6 is supported because that is the latest framework and is supported by this. It also supports the older frameworks, not a problem. But Visual Studio 2022 is the only IDE which supports .NET 6. You cannot use Visual Studio 2019 or 2015 to develop .NET 6 applications. Let's click on create. And if you are, just remember one thing, that if you are creating, if you are installing for the first time any Visual Studio, then it will ask you to select a theme and the default language. So those things it may ask you. So you can select just whatever theme you like. For example, some people like dark theme, or you can select different color themes. So my theme is different, where you can see a white background here. But there are also dark themes which are very popular nowadays, so you can select a dark theme as well. So you can see when I select console application, so by default this program.cs has come up, and it is mentioned here console.write hello world. So what I will do is I will perhaps write here read line or read key so that it will wait for me when I run this. And let's now run this. So the build has started and it is succeeded now, and the console has opened up. So you can see hello world. So that's very simple. We just wrote it there to the console and it is appearing here. So let's hit any key and then it will stop. So that's how you can download Visual Studio. You can install it and then you can run an application. So if you have any questions, then please comment below, and please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot for watching.